tongue has the power of life and death, and those who eat love it will eat of its fruit. So let's talk about what we can do. So I want you to leave here today with some practical ways. Think before you speak, talk less, commit your words to God, and hide God's word in your heart. So I'm going to quickly go through these real quick. So think before you speak, okay? Number one, do not be quick with your mouth. I mean, the Bible is teaching us, don't be quick to speak, right? Okay, and then look at the second verse. Think about, I want everyone to think about a conflict you just had. It could be with your spouse, a child, a parent, you know, sibling. Everyone should be quick to listen. What if you were quick to listen that day? What if you were slow to speak? And what if you were slow to be angry? Could that conflict somehow been avoided? The third verse, those who control their tongue will have a long life. Opening your mouth can ruin everything. That's so true, right? I mean, you could be in the middle of an argument and you said something and then you could regret it. So it can ruin everything. And this last verse is very interesting to me because we all can probably picture someone in our mind. If anyone considers himself religious and yet does not keep a tight rein on his tongue, he deceives himself and his religion is worthless. Right? So unfortunately, there are people, they know the word, they come to church every Sunday, but then they're gossiping. And so so in your mind, you're just kind of, you're torn. You're like, what is going on? But that religion is worthless. So religion that God truly honors is when we are practicing God, when we're practicing God's word, not just preaching it. So, and you've probably heard this acronym. Is it T-H-I-N-K? T-H-I-N-K. Think before you speak. Is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? And is it kind? So, you know, you're on the phone with your sister, you're about to share something, you think, T-H-I-N-K. Is it true, helpful, inspiring, necessary, or kind? And then talk less, a few verses in Proverbs and Psalms. When words are many, sin is not absent. Set a guard over my mouth, O Lord. So just imagine this is like our gate, and once we open it, words come out, we can't take them back. And a gossip betrays a confidence. The third one down, avoid a man who talks too much. I thought that was an interesting verse. I mean, you know, we know a lot of people that maybe talk a lot, and sometimes when you talk a lot, you say things you shouldn't say. So avoiding that, because you might get caught into that trap. And then he who guards his mouth and his tongue keeps himself from calamity. Abraham Lincoln was fond of saying, it is better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to open your mouth and remove all doubt. Okay, so when should I be quiet, okay? And we've all been there. When you're tempted to say, I told you so. When you have information that makes someone else look bad. When someone is upset about a problem and you want to shift that focus to yourself, right? And when you're tempted to judge or criticize somebody. When you want to correct someone on a minor point that they tell in a story, you know how we kind of butt in or we want to interrupt them. When someone has not asked for your opinion, or when you want to tell someone yourself in order to impress someone else, right? So you want to tell, this is what happened to me kind of thing. So that's when you know you need to remain silent. Okay, and then I'm towards the conclusion, damage control. So what do? You said it, and you can't take the words back, so what do? Okay, we've all been there. The Bible says, if you have been ensnared, trapped, you know when you're in a trap, there's no exit? The Bible's so good, like, he gives us an exit. We don't have to be condemned by the words that we say. If you've been ensnared with the words of your mouth, been caught with the words of your mouth, do this then, my son. Deliver yourself. Go humble yourself, okay? Give no sleep to your eyes. Yes. So that tells me, don't wait, okay? Because the longer you wait, the more complicated things get. So you go humble yourself, which is so difficult to do. So it can be awkward. It means picking up a phone. It means, hey, can we go have coffee? I need to talk about something I said wrong. So I just want to, you know, clear the air. Mm-hmm. So sometimes it can be awkward, but we have to follow the Bible's instructions. Yeah. And then I want you to commit your words to God. Ask God, tell me, how is it that you want me to speak today? Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and your plans will succeed. And I love this second verse. Conduct yourselves in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ, because we're all women of integrity, right? So we have to conduct ourselves because we are sending an example to the world. Christ is living us. We're the temple of the Holy Spirit. And so what words come out of our mouth really reflects who we are inside. And then the last word, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. And then last but not least, hide God's word in your heart and memorize scripture. And this is very simple, but it's so true. You know, really taking that time to read God's word. And life is busy. There's so many excuses that we can come up with. But if morning doesn't work, then try evening. But really, when you're in the word, like, God really speaks to you and he gives you discernment. I think that's what we all need. And memorizing scripture when you're in those situations that you're, you know, where it's questionable what you should say. So I want to thank you, and I just praise God for this opportunity. I want to just close with a word of prayer. Father, I just thank you and praise you for this time, and I just pray you help us to control our lips, put a guard over our lips, Father. Help us to say the words only when it's necessary, and we just love you. We just thank you for this time. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen.